Hello everybody, Jester here, and welcome back to Elder Scrolls Online, where today, as you can see, a brand new character. This is Hulgar Icebeard. He is a Nord sorcerer who specializes in frost magic and fights for the Daggerfall Covenant. Now, I haven't quite come up with a backstory as to why that is, but the Covenant is the only alliance I don't really have a character in, and I just think that the Nords are really cool, and pretty much their lore names really give, you know, like a lot of chance to, you know, include his professionalism, such as Icebeard specializes in frost magic, and plus he's got a pretty nice beard. So anyway, this is 1.6 update 1.6 with the brand new tutorial level. So let's see what we've got. I will play the tutorial level. The Wailing Prison. Tamriel is gone. You are going someplace else. Someplace far from the world you know. Someplace wrong. That's an awesome picture of Monarch Baal. Oh, here we go. Soul Shriven in Cold Harbor. Here we go. And as you can see, when you move from side to side, there's a bit of view bobbing. Very nice.
Whoa there. Are you all right?
Already different. Oh crap, yeah, I've got to change my controls. Crap, how do I...
You've still got some fight left in you. You're going to need...
How do I... Ah, that's how I... Yeah, okay, and...
Dead. Must have been the run.
Wait a second, first of all... Alright, yeah, okay. Your controls, I'll be right back. Okay, and that seems... That's me got my controls in working order. Cast off Iron Greatsword. Oh, God.
Keep your weapon ready and stay sharp. This place is full of surprises.
No, why? Could they not have just kept that one part where you could actually choose what kind of weapon you wanted? Because
there are more Daedra on
that was the only part of any actual game that I've ever played that you can, you know, like this, that you can actually choose what kind of weapon you wanted. You had a choice of a two-handed weapon, sword and board, or a staff.
Don't stop now. Keep moving.
But now you're forced to go with a great sword. Why? I chose the sorcerer class, which is just because I'm a Nord. So yeah, so as you can see, the tutorial level. Very different. Okay, and yep, as you can see, the blue border, and it actually, you know, it actually pauses to give you, whoa, and it focuses your camera on the thing. Very nice, a proper tutorial level too. Here's the prophet.
Greetings, Leslie.
Like you, I am a prisoner in this place. You must rescue me, and I, in turn, must rescue you.
Hold a moment.
I wonder if they fixed that bug yet when you first enter Tamriel and the prophet's ghost has a different voice actor. Lyris!
Prophet. He's a prisoner here, too. It was very dangerous for him to speak to you, even for a moment. You must think you can help me.
Help you do what?
Break him out, of course. Believe me, I can use all the help I can get. That blind old man is the only person alive who can help us get back home. Tamriel's a long way from here.
Where do we go from here?
These tunnels will eventually take us to the Towers of Eyes. That's where we'll find the Sentinels.
What are these Sentinels?
Magical constructs created by Molag Bal to guide his vision in Cold Harbor. The Sentinels are connected. If we destroy one, the others will be blinded. With any luck, that will buy us the time we need to free the Prophet.
And how can we destroy it?
I've no idea. Brute force? We'll find a way. We have to. Be ready for anything. I doubt Molag Bal left the Sentinels unguarded.
Okay then.
We should keep moving.
So, defeat Vaykar the Forge Master. This will be our first boss battle. And as you can see, the health of the enemy is actually going down now. And yes. And boom! And I leveled up. Nice. And also, you probably noticed that the weapons now have got far higher attack damage. Fire, because I think the first greatsword used to be only about, I don't know, 6 damage, I think. I'm not quite sure. Put that into Magicka, and... sure, let's go for Crystal Shard. That's a pretty cool one. That's kind of the Stone Fist of the Sorcerer's skill line. Knocks your enemies down. Though it does take a couple of seconds to, you know, to cast. You've got to summon the shards and then send them at your enemy.
A lot of schemes can see every part of Cold Harbor. We need to distract him.
So yeah, that's not a player. Yeah, as you can see, so much different now. You've got the chain forges, chain link forges. You've got bridges across the, yep. As you can see that. And as you can see, they're swirling around the Dremora's feet. That means that he's immune to knockdowns now. Because obviously when you knock him down once and now, they're immune to knockdowns for a while. So, you know, obviously Stone Fist will not be as overpowered as it once was. So. And also, here's a little tip for all of you Elder Scrolls noobs, or if you're planning on getting the game. Spend some time in this area, because there's chests around that contain some armor and weapons. Bloody, how could I forget the word weapons? Yeah, you'll find chests about the place that contain armor and weapons. Also, as you can see, I don't have any of my add-ons on. That's because I haven't activated them yet for 1.6. But obviously when they get updated, that'll be good. But there are some add-ons that will work in 1.6. Such as the bar that used to be along the top. But here we go. Wait a minute. Oh, yep. Oh, on Earth. Did I hear that guy twice? I think I hit that guy twice. Sorry, mate. Okay, so that was a chest. So as you saw, I had a shield in there. That was a player, Emilian, level 4. So she's obviously got the right of it to spend some time in here, which also will level you up. And also, this Crystal Shard has got a far longer range than Stone Fist. There you go. So chests. I used to know all the locations for the chests, but now, no idea where half of them are. Come on, and there you go. You had and rawhide boots. Already getting a little bit of armor on us. Speaking of which, how much armor do we have? Armor 80. So that'll just be for the rawhide boots. Chest, maple shield again. There you go, knock you down, and wail on you for a bit. We could really do with a staff. Any staff. Oh, green rawhide guards. Very nice. Mint, here's one of the new provisioning materials. Mint. Now, mint is not actually required for any recipes, but it will add stuff like flavouring. And it will up the, buffs you get. That's one of the new things we're provisioning. I'll probably show you a little bit later on one of my other characters. Fuel social event. Done. Dead! You're dead! Ali, you're dead! When did I hear that line before? I've heard that line somewhere. You're dead! Ali, you're dead! Damn it, didn't block that in time. That'll kill him anyway. Where the hell are all these chests? You know what? I'll probably level up to about level 4, then I'll be right back with you. Okay then, so first of all, there's a couple of changes. As you can see down there above my health bar, I actually made a new character. Obviously the last one was a Nord, and I kind of decided that maybe a Nord wasn't really the best kind of race for this sort of class. So I instead went for a Breton. And that is mainly because of the racial skill line, which is based around Magicka, which is what I want this character to be pretty much based off of. So he is Edward Iceheart, doesn't have a title yet. These are pretty much his stats so far. I put 2 points into Magicka, he's a Breton sorcerer, and I'm wearing an iron cuirass, soul shriven sandals, and rawhide guards of health, along with a garnet necklace, which increases my maximum stamina. And I'm wielding a maple ice staff of shock, which is, of course, a very unique combination. So, I've got pretty much everything that I want. I've got 2 skills on my bar, Crystal Shard and Mage's Fury. So now, the chests haven't really been respawning. So, we're going to, I think, just head off and go to destroy a Sentinel. And also, I've been collecting provisioning materials. As you can see here, some rose, mint, cornberry, yerba mate, white meat, all that sort of stuff. So now we're going to head off and start off with a... What are you doing teleporting towards me? Yeah, we're going to go ahead and... I cannot loot this guy. I cannot... Why can I not? There you go. Okay. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and destroy his sentinel now. Now keep in mind, if you watch the very start of my Mage's Guild questline, you will know that, well, you've seen the old tutorial level. You know, the one that used to, you know, well, the old one before 1.6. Now you are seeing brand new and improved tutorial level for Elder Scrolls Online. Sure, you've already seen all the differences. Correct, that's the last thing we need. So here we go, here's a Sentinel. Now, as you can see, it's an actual eye now. And you've got to sneak... Yeah, you've got to sneak past the eye. There you go. Done. Obviously, the eye sees you, then you'll be reset back to the beginning, which, of course, is a far better method than the last one, because the Sentinels are supposed to be watching over Cold Harbor, so they should be able to see somebody walking up and hitting them in the face. Or the eye, I suppose, would be the right word. Now, let's just get rid of this feral soul shriven. There you go, done. Destruction staff. Didn't the weapon used to be split into fire, frost, and guess not. That could be pretty useful. Wall of elements, destructive touch. Okay, and we'll check all that out once we've got a skill point to spend.
None can escape my prison of Cold Harbor.
Wagging tongue. The door's warded. We'll never get in this way.
You think? I'd never have guessed. Keep that mint. Sorry, Laris, hang on. I'll be just a sec, just gathering some materials. Okay, Laris, what were you wanting to talk to?
Damn it. Destroying the Sentinel must have triggered these wards. We'll need to find another way in. Maybe Cadwell can help us.
Who's Cadwell?
Cadwell is the oldest of the Soul Shriven. After years of torment, Soul Shriven usually go insane and turn feral. But not Cadwell. He was already insane before he left Tamriel. Mad as a box of frogs, but completely harmless. You'll see.
How could a madman possibly help us?
Cadwell sees things as he wishes them to be. To him, Cold Harbor is a wondrous place. It's his home. Knows it like the back of his hand. He's usually down by the river. Let's go find him.
Okay. He's right here too. I'm just gonna have a very quick last second look about for chests, nothing. Okay. What's this? I can eat that. What does it do? I threw up. Nice. Okay, Cadwell.
Hello, what's this? Out for a stroll then? Lovely day for it.
You must be Cadwell.
Sir Cadwell, yes, indeed, a pleasure. And fair Lyris, good to see you, my dear. How are you then?
We're trying to get inside the Prophet's enclosure. The door is sealed.
Oh dear, oh dear. Well, that is inconvenient, isn't it? Tell you what, I happen to know another way in. Much more of a scenic route. Rather a fun little jaunt, actually, full of traps and corpses and nasty beasties filling up the bits in between.
And how do we get through all that?
Rather cautiously, I expect. Watch your step, hold your nose, and do mind the traps. There'll like as not be a fair dose of running and skull bashing as well.
Where's the entrance?
Follow the river. You'll find the door to the Undercroft at the water's end. Once you're inside, stick to the light, and you'll find a ladder that will take you right up to the Prophet straight away. Do give him my best.
Thank you very much.
Best of luck.
Okay, so we're going to the Undercroft. Yeah. So also, everybody, I noticed in the last episode, when I fought Molag Bal, the voice audio was a little bit low for the characters. So I went ahead and turned it up to 92, rather than just keeping it normal, rather than just keeping it at the default, which is what I usually do.
The sooner we get that door open, the sooner we can get out of here.
I know. There we go. So and you had to pick that lock as well. Obviously, brand new mechanics, skeletal warrior. These are what used to be in the original prison.
That might have been a fair fight.
Almost one shoes of health. I shall take them. Do not need that sword. Come on in. There you go. Let's see, there are also some chests in here as well, as you can see right here. And a dagger, we can sell that at home, back in Tamriel. I think that's the way forward, which means that there's going to be something over here. And by the way, I've never played a mage character before, so this is just going to be me taking it by wing, or playing it by ear. So, yeah. Nope. There you go. Just got to pyromancer. Come on, hit the bloody pyromancer. There you go. Here's an get that frog. Iron battle axe. Now the lockpick I will take. That's empty. Okay.
This is the part where you bleed to death.
Where who bleeds to death? Where are we? There's a soul shriven. There you go. You had some gold, yep. Okay, you want to wait for these to stop. I think. Maybe not. Come on in. There you go. Knock you down. Perfect. Maple Restoration Staff of Frost. Not going to use that, but we can just sell it. There you go, Skeletal Warrior. I will take that.
It looked painful.
Get another knockdown. That. I'm not taking a lot of damage, am I? I suppose that is probably the point of being a wizard, a sorcerer. Infernal staff, do not want or need. Because, yeah, obviously, you usually wear light armor as a sorcerer, and light armor obviously doesn't give you the best armor. Heavy armor, of course, will give you the most armor, but light armor, not the best protection. Here's the Prophet's cell. Personally, I prefer the big, the prism thing. Prism thing magic. But yeah, this is still pretty cool.
We made it here in one piece, and the Prophet looks unharmed. Now the bad news. It's going to be up to you to keep us safe and get him back to town.
Excuse me?
There's a trick to opening the cell. The only way for a prisoner to leave is for another living soul to take their place. I need to swap places with the Prophet.
Is there no other way?
There was, but I don't see anyone else here with a beating heart, do you? If Molag Bal isn't stopped, he'll destroy everyone and everything we've ever loved.
If anyone you are. Come on. Do I need to talk to you again? No, there's just a little bit of lag. Lewis! Oh. Oh yeah, I've watched the Okay, defend Lyris this time. Very different. Probably should have leveled up once more. Dremora Bounikin. Probably a grown up version of the Banekin. Where? You! I love Banekins. They're far better than bloody scamps. Scamps are really annoying. They're far too beefy. Oh, I've got to activate the pinions. Yeah, the scamps have got too much health. They're bloody tedious and annoying because it takes a while to kill them and they just keep on hitting you and hitting you and hitting you. Now that is an awesome animation. Prophet.
Thank the divines, you are safe. There is that.
I haven't fixed that mouth clipping bug.
Her sacrifice must not be in vain.
Can we find a way to take her with us?
I wish that were possible, but I promise you, once we escape Cold Harbor, we will find a way to rescue her together. Vestige.
Vestige?
That is the name I have given you. You are but a trace of your former self, a soulless one, an empty vessel that longs to be filled. It is as the scrolls foretold. But not exactly as I imagined.
Why does Lyris call you the Prophet?
That is what I've come to be called. My true name is lost, even to me. Years of torment have taken their toll. Quickly,
excuse me.
We must make haste to the anchor.
Anchor?
The anchors are Daedric machines of the darkest magic. Their chains bind our world and pull it towards Cold Harbor. I can use one of these anchors to return us to Tamriel, but you must lead me to it.
All right then, stay close.
Up the stairs, quickly. We must get to the anchor mooring.
Very well, Prophet. I'm not going to loot anything else, actually. Yeah, I think I'm not really going to level up this character. I'm going to save this character for if a friend of mine gets the game and he or she decides to play in the Daggerfall Covenant. That way, they can have a little guide throughout the Daggerfall Covenant. Like a proper guide.
There it is. The dark anchor.
Here's Molag Bal.
Well done, mortals. But this is the realm of death itself. The armies of
a new voice actor?
Are endless.
Come, I will protect you.
Done. Yep, this is going pretty well. Got to remember to keep him targeted though. If I want to be a mage. There you go. Caller of Bones. Nice, add some maximum health. Very nice, I will take that. Talk to the Prophet.
The Dark Anchor's portal is high above us. I will prepare a spell to lift us to it. But first, you must reattune yourself to Nern in order to regain your physical form. To do this, you will need a Sky Shard.
A Sky Shard?
A shard of ethereal magicka that carries the essence of Nern. Some link them to Lorcan, the missing god of creation. If you collect them and absorb his power, it should restore your corporeal form. I will summon one of these shards for you to absorb.
I'm ready. Collect the Sky Shard.
Shard of Aetherius, fall upon us now and anoint us with your blessing.
Bloody hell, that's four dark anchors.
There, quickly, collect the Sky Shard.
Very well. Oh, we've changed the Sky Shard animation a little bit. The arms are a little bit more bent. Or folded. Bent? Yeah, bent is probably the big word.
Dragon God of Time, I require your strength. Let the way be open.
Look how awesome this pose is. That's just awesome.
Let the will of Molag Bal be denied.
Whoa.
Hurry, we must go now.
Also, this is automatic now. Before you had to activate the air in order to lift up, but now it's just automatic. Fantastic. And as you can see, brand new artwork. There's brand new artwork for a few of the loading screens. For Stoneforest loading screen, Eastmarch, I think the Rift as well, I'm not sure. But yeah, there's a lot of brand new artwork for the loading screens and for the login screen as well. Whoa.
The vestige awakens once again. Come here. We must speak.
Oh, did they fix that bug? Wait a minute, there's nothing else here. And I leveled up! Nice!
As I feared, we
arrived. No, they didn't fix it. Damn it.
I am in a city of industry where men speak of intrigues and plots beneath layers of innuendo and pleasantry. It matters not. You have awakened once again, and we must set you on your path.
How long was I unconscious?
Days, weeks, I cannot...
Just skip on this. Sealed urn and a skill point. Okay, let's see what's in this urn. Sentinel's Lash and Erzacene's Worn Jacket. Okay then. And we also got a skill point. First of all, let's just put that into Magicka and we've got two skill points. First of all... No, let's go for Destructive Touch actually. Yeah, and then as for ratio, no, can't get anything there. So let's just go for. I don't want lightning form and case. No, let's go for unstable familiar. That'd be pretty cool. This summons a little thing for us, and once we get to Morphic, we will transform this guy into a clan fear. So we'll have a little friend. So yeah, let's see this. Already got a racial motive. But this guy is not going to be a crafter. Well, he's going to be an enchanter, I've decided. But he's not going to craft any like armor or weapons. And with that being said, as you can see, actually, you know what? Real quick. Damn it. 75% chance. Yes! And as you can see down in the bottom right, I got 5
bounty. A blade cuts whatever it touches, just like you. I guess
no,
I
won't pay. Damn, where's the? Oh my God, it's all the way on the other side of the bloody town. Oh my God, I am so dead. It's all the way on the other side of town.
That's the criminal there.
Not a chance. Am I getting away with this? Not a bloody chance. Nah, okay, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and end off this ep. Really? Really? Okay, I'm actually going to end it off in the Outlaw's Refuge. Just to be safe. No, I'm going to have to steer clear of this lass. Come on, Outlaw's Refuge, please don't let there be any more guards. Oh, damn it, there's one right there. Wait a minute, that's the outside the city one. Okay, yeah, I'm just gonna have to avoid this guard. Get into the Outlaw's Refuge! Come on, Outlaw's Refuge! Damn it. Okay, where is the Outlaw's Refuge? Come on, it's just right around here. There it is, there it is! Gotcha! Yes! We got in the Outlaw's Refuge! Ha ha! What a daring escape! Most citizens of Daggerfall think the Red Rook bandits are the only menacing travellers on the wilderness roads. They'd never think to look for them under the cobblestones of their well-patrolled streets. Whew, that was close. Let's see, what did we steal? We stole a boar bristle brush. This simple brush is surprisingly stiff. It could just as easily be used to brush a mount. That's worth 30 gold. So then let's see. I think that's pretty much it for this episode. Let's just have a wee look see at this Outlaw's Refuge. Nice. So without further ado, I'm now going to end off this episode here. Hopefully you have enjoyed this video. If you have, be sure to leave a like down below and subscribe if you're not already. And share this video with your friends to expand the circus. And I will see you all in the next video. This is Jester, signing off.